Welcome to our new Ideas Powered for Business talk. Today, for the first time, with two stakeholders from our Ideas Powered for Business network. Our guests today are Susanna Bodi and Jan Bormans. I would like to start with a small definition of what is actually deep tech. Deep tech is technology rooted in scientific research and seeks to solve societal and environmental issues such as climate change, food security, or also access to healthcare. These technologies, such as artificial intelligence, machine learning, robotics, or facial recognition, are game-changing and will disrupt the way we use tools across all industries as we seek to create more effective, more efficient, and sustainable solutions. So my first question goes out to Jan. Jan, what is a deep tech startup?
Well, a deep tech startup, they are starting businesses that use advanced science and technology to do things that are deeply relevant for our society. So just like any other startup, they are very risky. They are in search of a unique and profitable business model that ideally scales very quickly. And therefore, they are in need of non-traditional financing methods like venture capital. But because deep tech startups use this complex and advanced science and technology, they will typically take much longer than other startups to reach the market and generate revenue. This means that it takes more time to cross the appropriately named valley of death. So not only are the science and technology aspects of deep tech startups more difficult, the business challenges they face are typically also much harder. This complexity means that well-functioning ecosystems with support and collaboration often become very crucial for the success of deep tech startups.
Susanna, Jan spoke just about the need to reinforce the ecosystem for startups and in general to prepare the Europeans for the deep tech. So hasn't EIT launched recently the Deep Tech Talent Initiative?
Yes, Sabina, that's correct. The Deep Tech Talent Initiative aims to provide skills to a million people in deep tech fields over the next 3 years. This is due to the fact that Europe currently lacks the talent and skilled labor to leverage new technologies for green and digital transition. As part of the European Commission's new innovation agenda, this program aims to address this issue, the talent gap, by developing a strong European deep tech talent pool. And this will happen through creating deep tech courses offered by EIT and the Pledger community, as well as funding to develop new or scale existing learning materials in deep tech.
So who can actually apply for this initiative?
Right, so our community is inviting education and training providers, enterprises, also financing organizations to take part and join the pledge for deep tech talents with their own initiatives and trainings. Their registrations can be submitted directly through the initiative's website, eitdeeptechtalent.eu. And those who are pledging will become members and they will benefit from the visibility through the initiative's platform, as well as they probably get access to funding and they benefit from the platform services. Beyond the pledgers, we also invite all those parties interested to emerge in deep tech offered opportunities, those learners and students as well.
Thank you, Susanna. Jan, why is actually intellectual property relevant for deep tech? What are the challenges and opportunities in a deep tech startup?
Okay, so because of the longer time to market that we discussed before, deep tech startups are typically more vulnerable in terms of intellectual property or IP. And so IP cannot just be an afterthought like it sometimes is or was, but it should now be an integral part of the startup strategy. Basically, I see three main challenges and opportunities. One, deep tech startups will need more patient capital providers. So let's help these startups to think about IP as collateral or guarantee in such a context. Two, deep tech founders often have an academic background where publishing is important, but where IP and brand protection are sometimes not so well understood. So IP education could probably be beneficial here. And finally, third, in ecosystems, deep tech startups collaborate with universities and corporates. And so these startups are more often than not the weak partner with respect to IP expertise. So let's make sure we go for fair win-win solutions for IP ownership. And maybe we need charters of good conduct here. So let's grasp these opportunities together.
I would like to conclude with the three main takeaways of this talk on deep tech and IP. Due to their nature, intellectual property is essential for the success of deep tech startups. Let's make sure that all stakeholders involved are aware of this and let's support them. If we get this right, we will be able to unleash the true potential of the European innovation ecosystems. And finally, we invite you to spread the word and apply for the Deep Tech Talent Initiative put in place by the EIT community. Thank you very much for joining and see you soon on one of our next talks. Bye.